Right, well.
Have you started?
I have started.
All right, hello.
All right, hi guys, welcome back to another video by Viking Ventures, and this is episode 2 of the ZX9R project. We've got many parts to go on the bike today, and who's doing it?
Me, apparently.
Yeah, so I'm going to be standing and kind of just holding his hands and just guiding him through this process. So then when we crash this bike, I've got no one to blame but him.
Oh, thanks, man. just how do you get to the front sprocket on this?
It's in here, so you have to take that off.
So what's this part here?
That is a gear position sender.
All right.
So we'll start off by taking off all the fairings and stuff. We're going to need to tank off, we're going to need to take the seat off. Because we're going to do a full service first.
Okay.
May as well drop the oil out of it. And another thing as well is that it has passed its MOT.
Oh yeah, you put it in last week, didn't you?
Yeah.
Congratulations, Kawasaki.
Exactly, yeah.
And how was the first ride out?
Questionable.
Brakes.
Brakes didn't. I mean, obviously it passed its MOT, but it's just obviously when we explored in the last video, it was the front brake is just pretty much non-existent. You know, you've got it. There's so much.
Well, it must have been all right for the MOT.
But on the road, it's just like when you come to a junction or anything like that. Instead of you, because we ride obviously Ducatis, which are far superior in every way, shape, and form. Let's not forget this. It's just there is so much travel on that front brake lever that it just makes it uncomfortable. Another thing as well is this gear lever for me. I'm size 12 and it is just, I find this just either too small. We have to just fanny around with this and just make sure that actually properly.
So is that adjustable then?
No, it's not adjustable, but what we can do is just rotate this so we can move either the lever down. I think it'd be more comfortable being downwards because it just felt as if, because your legs are bent up quite a lot. That you
so
have
you
to
with
like,
the balancing skills.
I know, mate. I'm just not amazing. But it just feels as if you've got to literally just bring your foot out underneath. It just makes like changing gear just very uncomfortable, should we say. But the clutch felt good. Everything else feels nice.
What's the suspension like?
It's a little bit floppy,
all right,
to be honest. It's nice for the road, but I just think that if you're on track.
We're going to have to tighten you up a bit then.
Well, we're going to have to strip and rebuild because you've got the forks to do, mate.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. So we've got.
So just for everybody who's watching, I haven't got a bloody clue.
Yeah.
So I normally put a bike into Chris to get worked on. So.
I know, but we've all got to learn somewhere, mate. This is the start of your journey, of your relationship bonding with the ZX9.
Are you filming this?
Yes. He is.
So he's one of our best buddies.
Big Steve.
Steve's come down for the crack and basically just to take the mick.
Yeah, that's it. That's what it's all about, mate. Right, so we've got a nice RC19 quarter courser to go on. So that's going to go on. That should hopefully sort out the whole braking situation. That obviously came off a Ducati because, you know, it just...
It'll be good then.
It'll be good, yeah. It might, to be honest, it might cause the bike to function in the way it was supposed to. Function because right. It is a proper component, but we've got a 520 race chain conversion kit to go on with a larger rear sprocket, smaller front sprocket, slightly lighter chain, obviously good quality stuff. We've got the GB Racing.
Oh, because we need brake. That for the track, don't we?
We do.
Yep,
we
yep.
can't apparently go on without it, so we've got that. We have got new frame bolt kits.
Shiny stuff.
Shido lithium battery you fitted last video.
All right, yep,
so that's
cool.
Already gone in. And then we've got fork dust seals. We've got fork seals. We've got fork oil. We've got titanium sprocket nuts. Because I just think that if you're putting a new sprocket, new chain,
they'll
things
look
like that, it's just going to
very
look
nice.
Shit if we put them old ones on.
Sponsored
there.
By eBay.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. You want to sponsor us, eBay, feel free. Another thing as well is I just want to have a massive shout out to the Ducati group based in Penrith. Little Steve and the whole gang. Yeah, they're all a good bunch of guys and gals. Right. Bobbins,
yeah,
because these ones just—they look
okay, man.
They look terrible. So
we'll do them when it's down.
We'll do them when it's down, yeah, because we'll get the back wheel off, because we want to check the caliper on the back, chain, sprocket, stuff like that. I'll show you how to do all this, mate. You'll be an absolute whiz by the time we're finished. New oil filter, we've got four new plugs, we've got a new fuel filter, new air filter. It should be...
excellent.
Excellent, yeah, exactly. Yeah, it should be excellent. So, we will get sorted out and yeah, bring you back once Mike's ready with tools in hand, ready to explore the world of.
So what are we doing first?
So,
bearing panels off.
First port call is going to be, yeah, if we can get this section off here, because we literally, so you'll undo these three, these two at the top here, you've got a main one here, we'll drop the main body fairing off, just give us good access, because to get to the plugs, we're going to have to lift the tank, remove the airbox, and replace
see what's in there.
See what's, because there could be many, many gremlins in there, seat off. That
no, I think it'll be fine. It's an awesome piece of Japanese engineering.
I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
And on that note, let the fun begin. Driver in a way. So, yeah, we're just removing the.
Have we got new fixings?
We have got new bolts and stainless steel fixings and fixtures for this bike, which is going to go on. Compliments of eBay. Again,
so it's worth us whipping this indicator out while we're here. Then, if we've got this panel off, have we?
Well, I mean, you might want to use it on the roads just to have an idea as to what we're doing. Do you know what I mean?
You just want to have a thrash.
Well, we're going to have a thrash, mate. We're going to have a thrash once you've put in all this effort and. You know, Mike's worked his mechanical wizardry, you know, perfecting the bike and getting it absolutely tip-top.
I can strip any boiler you want in theory and get it working.
To be honest, mate, the way that mechanics works, you know, that is, you kind of, you know, you're halfway there. As long as you remember or, you know, you can strip stuff down and put it back together, it's just remembering where all these parts go, and that's kind of half the battle. Yeah, so you keep all your bolts and screws and whatever else together, you know, and then when you remove the part, take the bolts and everything with it, you know, so that's just spinning that, isn't it? No, that is coming out, yeah. But, yeah, while he's fanning around all
so what we're going to do with these cracks, are we going to, like, fiberglass it up from the inside or
we
something?
We could fiberglass it up, yeah, I've got fiberglass in.
I do prefer this sticky tape on the outside look, though.
Do you? I know what you're saying. Well, it does make it very quick and easy, like making a cake.
So what did you have for breakfast?
I had fresh air for breakfast, because that is a part of a substantial go faster, lightweight, track fit body ready freaking breakfast. What did you have for breakfast?
Well, I had that bacon sandwich that I bought and then the same one that I brought you.
Oh, shit, yeah, I had a bacon sandwich as well. Yeah. See, this whole track body crack is just, it's gone out the window already, to be honest. Look at this, look, and somebody's drew a picture of Mike on the back of the bike. This is just uncalled for. Absolutely uncalled for. You offended, Mike?
No, not so.
No. Have a closer look at some of these parts in here. That rear shock looks a little bit tired. But it did feel quite good, though. It's on its maximum adjustment, this rear shock, as well, so we're not going to be able to get it any stiffer than what it is.
Is it?
Aye. We're going to take all of these parts off, so we're going to be able to have a bit of a closer look at what's going on. Get in there and have a look at that. These calipers and stuff. I know the fork seals are really badly gone, but this is the brake lever travel that I was telling you about. I mean, that is just... for me, and I think for Mike as well, that is just going to be far too much. I mean, the brakes are strong, they are okay. I just don't like having so much travel. I'd say we'll replace that new, replace it with that RC19 brake lever. Now, Lindez, enjoying yourself? Yeah? Yeah, she's enjoying herself. How are we getting on, Big Mike?
I think you're, is your ratchet plane up?
Yeah, that's the broken one. Use the, where's the green one gone?
This one I got you for Christmas?
No, this one, use. Use that one.
Thanks, man.
That's all right, mate. You can use the, there's new, nice new shiny sockets up down there.
Sponsored by Halfords.
Sponsored by Halfords. Oh, you've got a lower one as well, mate, down here.
Is it?
Yeah. It's a number 4 Allen key, I think. I'll just shorten this stick a little bit so you can hold on to you a bit better. Some of these are going to be a bit seized, I think. This one works conventionally, mate, so lefty loosey, right.
I know, I'll just sort of do that, you know that,
look at this.
You know that thing where you tighten it and then loosen it?
Yeah.
Might have to get the blowtorch out on this.
That's got a rubber seal though.
Melt the plastic.
Yeah. Come on, Big Mike, I have faith in your mechanical abilities. That may snap, but it's okay. Man's a frigging waste with a spanner. Enjoying yourself, Mike?
I am.
Right, okay, so this bottom section here, we've got two fixtures under the front, yeah. Let's take that off and then we can have a closer inspection of some of these, these coolant
ovens. I think we've got to get the other side as well, haven't
we? Yeah, the other side. But the thing is you want to kind of try and get, just put that down there, mate, with your things. You want to try and get this whole top section of fairing off together. So if we leave that just up here for now, because we'll have to undo the other side. So if that just stays there, so if you undo the other side and then we can then remove that section. So we'll bring you back once he's done that. Right, okay, so we've removed the side fairing. Now we can see in here, just have a quick scan around. It's not actually looking too bad, to be honest.
Steve making brews?
Yeah, they're already poured, but go on, Steve. Make the brews, Mower. There's no sugar in any of them. It's just they just need probably just stirring. If you take sugar, yours is the fine right one, if I remember. Yeah. Not looking too bad. Need to take off this coolant expansion tank as well. See if we can get that. Oh,
chief mechanic is a lot of coffee.
Yes, needs a coffee to keep him alert.
Keep him away.
Thanks, man. I guess. Right, so good girl.
Chief cameraman.
Aye. Nice one, cheers, lad. Spot on. Can't beat a good route. So.
Tell you what, this radiator is looking a bit like
it's
seen
looking
better days,
a little
it?
Bit manky, isn't it? Especially like even from this angle, I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up too well, but especially
to be fair, it's just full of shit.
It is full of shit, yeah. But you can see, like, in
look at that bit there.
This area here, you've got a massive split there. You see fucking daylight through it. I mean, it's holding fluid. For us, it's going to be all right for now.
Right.
As long as it's holding coolant and behaving itself, we have got the coolant flush to do anyway. I mean, that's probably something that we could also do today. If we just focus on doing the service, we can flush the radiator, check all the hoses and all that sort of stuff, because at the end of the day, if we're going to be thrashing it, we want it to not explode.
Yeah, we don't want the fan radiator going pop on us, do we?
Yeah.
Right, what's next?
So next is going to be, you're going to need to get a socket on here. Looks like a 17mm or an 18mm, and then crack that sump plug. So a quick butcher's round here. Yeah, it's not looking too bad, mate, to be honest, up to now. It's obviously a bit, you know, it's showing its age, but, you know, other than that,
bring the bike down for you.
You crack the nut first, mate, and then...
So we warmed this up earlier, didn't we, sir?
We did. It has been started and it has been warmed up. The shift me broke, because accidents do happen.
for what we are about to receive. May the Lord make us truly thankful.
I can't say stuff like that, mate, on bike adventures.
Yeah, I know, but we don't know what's going to come out of here. Right, you ready? If there's anything...
A bit a bit.
Why is the fish in the oil?
Right, let's have a look at this. Oh, that's not actually that bad. Just put your finger in it and smell it. I'm being serious.
Yeah, just sniff it.
Just smell the petrol.
Does actually.
Does it? All right, okay. So it's either the oil's been there for a long time. What else could that possibly be if it smells of petrol?
Somebody's put petrol in when they should be putting oil in. Have a sniff.
Yeah, that definitely smells of petrol. That's rich, that. So it could be definitely overfueling, mate, for one. Two is we're going to have to do a full compression test on it because that could potentially be petrol in the combustion chamber, seeping past the rings and getting into the bottom of the engine.
Right, okay.
So we will test that. So what we'll do is before we put, or no, saying that, we're going to have to do it after we put oil in it, but we're going to have to leave a bolt, like the oil filler cap. If we leave that off, and then we should be able to hear air coming out of it.
All right.
If there's any excessive amounts of air coming through, that's obviously surpassing the rings.
So as it's compressing during the combustion stroke, the compression could go past the rings and then come out past the...
Right, so what we'll do is that if we do feel that, another way of confirming this is to put oil in the cylinder, run the compression and test again. If it lifts the compression, we've confirmed our suspicions that the rings are on the way out.
But this is a prime piece of Japanese engineering, so it will be fine.
Do you share his optimism, mate? No. Right.
Okay. Have you got a thing for taking the filter off, then?
I have got a thing for taking the filter off. It is over yonder. But then saying that, Father P did have it last. So, it could, there it is. There is gloves, mate. There is gloves.
I know, but I'm a man.
I know what you're saying. Right, so we're going to let Mike take the filter off. I'm gonna swig coffee. Why is that going down like that? All right, Des, how's it going, lass?
Mike the mechanic.
I never actually thought I'd ever see such a thing, to be fair. Another good tip as well is to undo the oil filler cap.
Air in, oil out.
That's it. But that, yeah, oil does smell very, very petrol-y. Yeah, it stinks.
Can you smell it?
So what we could possibly end up having to do is stripping and rebuilding the carburetors, which is the one thing which we didn't order was a float or a carb rebuild kit.
It's not fuel injection then?
No, it's not fuel injection. How old is that filter? Does it look? It's rusty.
It's rusty.
It? Yeah, been on there for a while then. Considering it's only been used once for the track, it's. Let's have a quick show the camera. Yeah, it's been on there for a while, hasn't it? Yeah, definitely. Well, up to now, Mike, I am very impressed.
Anybody would think I've watched a YouTube video before I did this, wouldn't they?
You wore the crop in the mind. Yeah. Des, don't lean against the camera. What are you doing? Yeah. There should be a crush washer somewhere. Let's have a look at this one. That doesn't... Did this have a crush washer on it?
That's exactly how it came out.
Okay, fair enough. Right, okay, well. So what we're gonna do now, dip your finger in that oil.
That's already got some sort of...
It has like a Vaseline on it, but we'll just clean that off and just get a little bit of oil on there. Go. Make sure that you, before you put the oil filter on, the surrounding area is clean.
I've done that.
Have you?
Did you watch me?
I'm impressed. I am impressed. You're impressed. Yeah.
think he has watched that video.
Oh, I think he has, yeah. There's no way he knew about this a couple of weeks back. Oh, so what have we found, Big Mike?
Well, the low radiator support bracket.
Yeah.
This thing here.
Let's just see if I can get in there, mate. Go on, then. See if I can have a quick look.
What have you found? Talk us through it.
So, what I noticed was you got this hanging here.
Yeah.
Which, by the looks of it, goes there.
Goes in there, yeah.
Takes the play out of this radiator.
Right.
It looks like it's snapped off. Right. The bolt's still in.
Yeah.
The casting on the engine.
Yeah.
So we're going to soak it in some WD-40.
Yeah. Man is just an absolute genius. He's a wizard with the tools, isn't he? He knows.
Stop swearing.
He knows. I can't help it, mate. I'm absolutely blown away.
My mum's going to watch. My mum's going to watch this.
Is she? Is she really?
I hope not.
Hi, Mike's mum. How's it going? They say you can't teach an old dog new tricks, but. I beg to differ here.
Think how much you'll be wanted after this video.
There'll be girls on the phone all the time.
Oh, Magic Mike, change his name. Big Mike to Magic.
Magic Mike the stripper?
That's it, yeah, yeah. How's it going, Des?
Stripping clothes off.
That's it. Well.
It's going to be a 10.
Yeah, it will be a 10 mil, yeah.
It'll definitely be a 10 mil. Is looking a bit crusty. This nut here we're looking at, this box, just the layer, and then this bracket is supposed to connect right there. But
you wouldn't have this with the Ducati, you see?
No, you wouldn't.
Say again.
Also, wouldn't let you loose on the spanners.
Right, so we need another one of them.
Yeah, well, I'll add that to the list and we can get one of those, but let's have a look.
So that's a bit that goes to the radiator.
Yeah.
It's got a rubber bush in it.
Yeah.
And then that's the bit that's snapped off that goes onto the engine.
Okay, grand. You are, fella. I mean, you could do, yeah. That'd be a massive help, that. Are they saying that? Is it made of alloy steel? Because if it's made of steel, we can weld it. What do you reckon that is? It feels like aluminium to me. It's dead light, isn't it? I mean, if he could just spot that together.
Yeah, he could, eh?
Yeah, that could be a good help, that, mate. If he could sort that out for us, yeah, that'd be a massive, amazing help. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, I'll get it
to
do it and I'll just bring it to the next time
we see
him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Even see
him
this afternoon if he's
in
the workshop.
Yeah. Right, mate. That's much appreciated. That. Thank you very much.
I'm putting that bolt back in the engine and we know where it goes.
I've said it before, I'll say it again. I'm massively impressed here. This is good. Have you got like a little handbook that you've been looking at? it does, doesn't it?
Right, I've just nipped it up for now.
Grand job, grand job. So we're moving on to you next then. What should we do now? What do you think?
Drain plug back in and then stick some oil in it.
That's it, yeah. We'll do that. So he's going to fire the drain plug back in new. We will have to find out the torque spec for the drain plug and get that torqued up.
I already know that.
Do you?
Yeah, because I watched this YouTube video.
Did you?
No.
I was going to say, did you?
So you haven't got a crush washer for this, no?
It doesn't have a crush washer, mate, so to speak. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be like that. I was pretty sure that they all have crush washers, but let me just quickly just find out what the torque spec is for this sump plug.
Aren't it supposed to be like a copper crush washer or something?
Well, sometimes they're like an aluminium-y sort of, like really thin metal crush washer. Newtons. It is. And they say Google isn't useful.
is a little torque adapter.
And you're on time, Chris.
Yeah, I'm getting to it, mate. I'm nearly there. 20, and we need a half inch. What size is that bolt?
17
mil. Like that. And you can have this. There you go, mate. And then there's, you are in the way, sweetheart.
She's all right.
That's it. Just double check it, do it again.
Happy days.
That's it, perfect. Grand job. Engine, you typically on these bikes, there's usually an oil capacity, so you see, yeah, there you go.
Can't quite, it's rubbed off.
So filter removed, 3.3 litres we're gonna have to put in, but I would probably put it in until it's just above the max mark, just for now. And then we can start the bike, prime the system, and then top it up afterwards.
Des, just hold this funnel for me, will you?
Yeah, she said, nah, mate.
It's not happening.
It's not happening. Right, let me swap sides for you, because you're the man of the hour.
What's going on? This is liquid gold. What are you doing with the funnel?
Well, I can't tip it up anymore.
Oh, Chris, man.
He's bleeding and everything. Can't believe you shed blood over this, Mike. Sit nice and easy. Really do need to get a better funnel.
You do need to get a better funnel.
Yeah.
Don't you think, Steve?
I think so.
Des, don't you think Chris needs a better funnel?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's just
agreed. Oh, thanks, man. When did they start putting oil in bags like this, then?
It's just like a eco-friendly...
Since we're in hospital.
Yeah,
oh. Right, Big Mike.
Sorry, Steve, did you say you were going?
Yeah. See you later, lad.
See you later, mate. Take care.
See you later, man.
Right, for anybody who doesn't know, this is Doris. Say hi, Doris.
Hi.
He's the shop apprentice. We sculpted this picture based on him, didn't we? Yeah.
Can we give him loads of abuse on the video?
Yeah, we can give him abuse, yeah. You're open to abuse, aren't you?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. See?
Nice t-shirt.
He's a good lad. He's wearing it. At least he's got a proper t-shirt. Not so sure about the haircut, though.
What's next?
Next is the fuel tank seat, because we want to change the plugs and we want to have a look at the airbox, check out the air filter. We've got replacement filter to go in. We've got the four new plugs to go in.
I'm going to put this filler cap back on for the time being, all right?
That is a good idea. Why is it a good idea, Big Mike?
So we don't get anything in there by mistake.
Yeah, that's correct, that, isn't it? You impressed, dude?
I'm impressed, I'm very impressed.
Yeah. Are you still here?
Yeah. Can't part.
He's attached to it.
Take your wallet, it won't part.
But you're enjoying yourself so far, Big Mike? Yeah?
Nowhere else I'd rather be.
I know what you're saying. Oh, and there's the battery that you fitted a couple of weeks ago. Still functioning beautifully. I do rate these Shido batteries, they are good. Still fully charged. We'll need the battery connected for now. So we've got two bolts here at the back, mate. These two. You have to disconnect this, this tank breather. And then you've got two bolts at the front. I think that's a number 5 Allen key at the front, number 5 at the back. Or it could be a number 6. Yeah, it's a number 6.
What these are?
Yeah.
What do you do to disconnect that fuel line there? Just pull it off?
This is just a breather hose, this.
Ah, right.
So, okay. You might need to get a flathead screwdriver and just persuade it around the edges a little bit. That's obviously, yeah, a little bit on the tight side. We should have new bolts for this, though. Should have. Yeah, take that space around as well now. Remember the orientation of that, because that's where the last person messed up and put that round the other way.
Oh, did they? Is that why the seat wouldn't fit properly?
Yeah.
They weren't highly trained professionals like us, were they?
Well, that's it, mate, yeah. There we go, beautiful, beautiful. If you could just get a small flathead screwdriver, so then that will help out Big Mike in his quest for a move on the tank.
That just push off there?
You could do, but sometimes it might be a bit stuck on. Has he done it? Oh, it's all right, mate, he's done it. He's just an absolute wizard.
That YouTube video helped out again.
It's really sorted you out. Right, so we've got the ones at the front to do next, mate.
So I'll give that a...
Watch out, Des. I can't watch what I'm doing. I might stand on you. You smell lovely, Joel.
Does he?
He does. He smells sexual, mate.
Is it not? Shame we haven't got smelly vision, innit?
I know.
So that should just lift up now, should it?
Don't lift the whole thing. Just lift from the rear because we're going to have a fuel line which connects to this fuel tap. So we want to find out how that's connected. Just give him a lift there, Joelidge. And you'll see that this pipe here needs to come off. So you're going to need a set of grips to get hold of that thing. And then, which I will provide.
They're up there.
How many blokes does it take to move a fuel pipe? There we go. Should have breather pipes on that as well. So you have to just double check underneath. Make sure that they're disconnected. If we're all clear, try and pull it away.
You see anything? Look at that. Beautiful. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Beautiful. Right, I'll just lift this pipe up to stop fuel from pissing out all over the place. Right, now we can see its undercarriage. It looks all right, mate. It looks quite clean. Ish. Just usual standard stuff.
Do you reckon you take this airbox off then?
Yeah, what we'll do is, so you're going to need a 10mm, undo all of these, we'll inspect the condition of the air filter and see what lies beneath.
It's a British thing,
isn't it? It is a proper British thing to say, yeah, but they are, just, you've got all your veg in there, you've got your Brussels, broccoli, green beans, carrots.
Hey, I like that.
That as, this is a three piece, so this is actually quite old. Yeah, that's... Right, I don't like all of that crap in there. So whoever it was that did this last hasn't cleaned out the airbox prior to putting in the new filter in it. Smells, obviously it's going to smell of petrol, but...
We stink of petrol at the minute, don't we?
Can't be worse than a fire blade.
It's definitely not as bad as a fire blade, no, but... Yeah, it's got rust spots on it, so...
Who's fire blade?
Yours?
Well, it was mine minging.
There's a flathead in the fucking airbox.
All right.
You were told, mate. Yeah.
Somebody left a screwdriver in there.
They did leave a screwdriver in there, yeah. We won't mention no names. One thing is the airbox screw is loose. So whoever it was who was in here last didn't even bother to bolt up the airbox properly because that is just hand tight and I haven't stopped recording or anything like that. And
so we're taking this off or leaving it on?
So this is going to come off. So what we're going to do is you're going to disconnect the two breather lines from here on the outside. You should have one. Oh no, there's just one on this side. You've got two.
There's one on this side here.
Yeah. And then you've got the air intakes, these things here. So you've got two clamps to undo. You've got that breather pipe at the back. This has got to come off. This is a crankcase breather. So we're going to disconnect that. That's off. That one, that's come off. Got this one on here, Joel. You may as well get that one, mate, if you can. You'll probably need a set of grips or something to get on that.
Yeah.
Just to pull that off. What about you, Joel? What would you have if you're going to have one meal for the rest of your life?
He's having that meat feet pizza. Meat feet pizza.
What, every single day for the rest of your life?
It's got a lot in it. It's got carbs, it's got meat, it's got fruit. Not fruit. Vegetables.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I know what you're saying. Well, I suppose everybody's different. I guess.
So if we were on a desert island,
yeah,
all our catering needs would be met because
if you brought Joel with us, we could just eat.
Well, we could eat his pizza. We could have your roast dinner and
your Chinese.
My Chinese.
Yeah. The only thing is, though, who goes on a desert island to survive and takes a roast dinner and try and...
Well, no, it'll get delivered, wouldn't it?
Get a little man in a boat to come over and... Here is your daughter.
Deliveroo.
Mr. Morgan. Right, so we'll wait for the next 20 minutes for Joel to get that pipe off.
Whoa, no need for that, is there, Joel?
And then we'll bring you back once we've got this airbox housing removed. Alright, so airbox removed.
Cylinder 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's it. It's labelled, it's kind of, idiot proof, really. Oh, I'm loving this. That piece of copper pipe there is supposed to be a bridge off of
tie wrapped
that.
On.
That's, just tie wrapped on. That could, I mean, as long as it works, which it obviously does, it doesn't feel very oily, does it, or anything?
No. Is that some sort of breather then?
It's a breather, yeah, but I'd imagine that actually came off with a T-piece and another piece of pipe was connected to the airbox. I could only imagine. What was connected to here then? Nothing. No pipe on the airbox or anything? So this is the carb overflow, so basically there should be a pipe which comes off of this and then runs down and discharges any excess fuel away from the engine. Because if we have any problems with the float
balls
of this bike, that is supposed to be on there by the looks of things, yeah. So
you've just disconnected that, haven't you?
If you disconnected it, sounds right, okay.
Yeah, it's a good job me and Joel are here, man. You'd be struggling without us.
Yeah. Right, so what I think we should do next is disconnect these lines. You've got this one here, so you need to get the grips on that, disconnect this, pull this hose away. This is going to be full of fuel, so we're going to replace that with a nice new shiny fuel filter. So just remember the orientation as well, because obviously don't want to fuck it up.
You're going that side, Joe. Thanks, man. Beautiful, that.
Lovely.
Perfect.
Lovely.
Thank you, YouTube.
Oh, no.
Chris, where are you? What time are you coming home?
Yeah, that'll be it. Who is it?
Big George.
Big George. Oh, I will speak to Big George. Right, Big Mike. What's next on the agenda?
Well, we've whipped the plugs out, myself and Joel, because I don't know, you were dossing about outside making phone calls or something. So me and the worker.
Yeah.
We got that sorted, so we whipped the plugs out.
Joel and worker, same sentence. Who was that?
So, on Joel's recommendation, we're now going to do a compression test.
Right, and then what should the compression be?
Well, because I've got an encyclopedic memory, and you told me about 30 seconds ago, it's supposed to be between 139 and 215, but around about 150 is good.
Yeah, I think anything around 180 plus is ideal, but 150 plus is what we want. So they were actually the exact words that I said to him, not even 50 seconds ago.
So what? So you just screw this compression tester into the spark plug
Do you? Yeah. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to hold the throttle wide open, obviously turn on the ignition.
And then just spin it over.
Run the starter until that needle on that gauge stops.
$195,
so that is healthy. That is very healthy. So we were looking for, ideally, anything over 150 is good, but 180 plus is good. So now what you need to do is hold that throttle wide open again, is put your ear into these. Joel, you put your ear to the exhaust. You want to see if we can hear anything coming out of there at all. Don't need to hold the starter or anything. Just put your just listen for anything. Any whistling?
Greg's. Steak bake.
Because by us checking this, what this is going to do is this.
I want to be a Ducati.
is checking the intake valves. So if we've got a potential leak on the intakes, then you'll be hearing air coming out of here. Same thing for the exhaust valves. Joel will be able to hear something coming out of there. The fact that that gauge isn't moving, we've got 190 psi. That shows me that cylinder one at least is a good.
Fair comment. Yeah.
So we've got three other cylinders to do. So throttle closed. So you press that decompression button on there. Right. And then
does this just twist out?
That will just twist out. Yeah. Shouldn't be that tight because we don't want to leave the tip in there because that will be not very good. There we go. Mm-hmm.
So what did we have? 195, 195 on the two outside ones.
So cylinder one was 190, cylinder two was 180,
180.
Cylinder three was 175, and yeah. Cylinder four was 195. So that's above, you know what I mean? That's a good, I'm well happy with that. So now we can go ahead with refitting the plugs. They can go back in.
Where are they? We'll put them somewhere safe.
They're down here. Get in there, you bugger.
Just drop them in.
Really bad for your knuckles, you know, when you do that.
Great work, team.
Because didn't they do like research on it? Well, they said like a guy cracked his knuckles on one hand for 30 years and didn't do anything.
Is that right? That?
Yeah.
I always thought that it was like cracking your knuckles and stuff is bad for you.
Mm-hmm.
Did it not give you arthritis or something like that?
Well, it's stupid. Then a guy did the research, we cracked one hand for 30 years but not the other.
Yeah.
That's the exact same.
Okay. You've learned something.
Are you being serious?
Yeah.
I thought it was really bad.
That is a conclusive medical test,
it was,
isn't it?
Dr. Doris, at your service for all your arthritic needs.
TikTok.
Yeah. Aye. So nice clean plugs going back in anyway. So we'll get the plugs back in, we'll get the airbox put back on. We've still got the coolant to drain. And then we can get it fired up. And hopefully she might run just a bit sweeter. But happy so far, Big Mike?
Yes, absolutely ecstatic.
Yeah. He's done such a good job today, honestly. I'm so proud of him. So proud of him. Right, we'll bring you back once we've got a few more bits done.
Just pushing this.
Right, so now we're putting the airbox base back on. Gonna get it all lined back up.
Come back up here, Joe. Perfect.
That's it, and then slide those air ducts onto it. It'll be quite a tight fit.
I've got these on, Joe.
So if you're finding it difficult, you'll have to work in from the bottom. It might be the bottom edge. You can disconnect that plug, mate, if it's in the way. Right, so while those two are going to be farting around with that, we're going to remove the rear wheel, remove the chain.
Yeah, mine's perfect.
Get rid of the nasty chain and sprockets, replace the nuts, because everything is pretty ghastly, as you can see. So we'll get rid of all of that. We've already cut the chain. We'll get a nice new shiny one put back on. So, we'll bring you back once that has been completed, because camera's starting to overheat a little bit, don't understand why, so we're going to have to not be so eager to record absolutely everything, unfortunately, but that's just the way things are. You guys happy up here? Got it?
Yeah, we are buzzing.
You're buzzing?
Buzzing.
Happy?
Yeah.
Yeah? Just double checking. Right, we'll bring you back in a minute. Right, so cut the chain off. Pull this pin out of here.
Mm-hmm.
she comes. How are you getting on, Big Mike?
Yeah, good.
Are these your bolts, mate, down here? There's one. There's two. I'll give you the rest, mate. There you go.
Thanks, mate.
So airbox has gone back on, new air filter, new fuel filter, new spark plugs, got the new sprocket to go on wheel with new nuts, new chain. Yeah, making some progress. Mike's loving it and enjoying himself. It's just,
it's nice and sunny, you know. We should be out on the bikes now.
We should be out on the bikes, to be honest. Yeah, it's beautiful. We've got Doris who's cleaning out the gearbox sprocket casing. It's looking much better than what it was, mate. It was horrible, wasn't it? Absolutely awful. Absolutely awful. Yeah? Yeah, well, it you get a lot of crap collecting them things, obviously, because it's all the old chain grease and stuff that all comes off. It all sticks in there. But they're doing a fine job, mate, a fine job. So, I'll crack on trying to get this bloody sprocket.
Listen, if you're struggling, me and Joel can do the chain of sprockets.
Yeah. What is that? 15 mil, is it? T-shirt. That would not be good. Nice new shiny nuts to go back on this. Answer my question earlier on, Big Mike.
What's that?
Then we were talking about if you went to Ducati factory.
Oh, which one would I take home?
Which one would you take home?
Well, they did this one that they made for the American police. Yeah. I think it's called the Apollo.
Yeah.
Which was like an original V4.
Yeah.
It was like a prototype. Obviously, they were going up against Harley Davidson at the time. And it's like, literally, there's only one.
Yeah.
But when we went to the museum, it wasn't there. But I know it was there previously. Exists. So for me, it's like a big, heavy, like, chunk of an American-looking thing.
What, and you would have that over anything else?
It's just the rarity of it, I think. Yeah, I think it's, like just quite a...
Yeah.
But then you've got the race bikes as well, haven't you? So you've got the likes of Pecco Bagnaia's...
Yeah,
MotoGP bike. As you know, I like...
You like rare bikes?
Well, I don't know. It's just like special stuff as well, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
So you've got Troy Bayliss's race-winning bike, haven't you?
Yeah, you are.
You know, that silver one. Yeah, and we saw the silver one when we went for the meet and greet with Troy Bayliss and Carl Fogarty and that.
Yeah,
you know, like, just every single part of it, you look at it and it's just, wow.
Yeah.
You know, special stuff, isn't it?
It is special.
I don't know. So that Pecco's MotoGP bike is just...
It looked like something out of Mad Max,
So much thought has gone into absolutely everything on it.
Yeah.
The, you know, the size and shape of the tank, the way that it's obviously designed for racing to suit him.
Yeah.
And then you've got the likes of Scott Smart's race bike from, you know, back in the day. I don't know. There's so much stuff.
Mate, this is looking sexy already. Titanium nuts, I can't believe it.
But that is just going to, it's going to tidy up this back end so much.
Don't know, what would you take from the Ducati factory then?
I think I would probably take Carl Fogarty's.
Would you?
996, I reckon. I don't know.
So they're literally the race bikes, aren't they?
The 916 and the 996, they are, that's what I was saying before, they're like proper Ducatis and like back in the day, you know, you know what I mean? You've got all of that like typical Ducati characteristics and the styling, and I mean, Ducati obviously make lots of nice machines, but I just think that's like one of like the old school, like great, isn't it? You got Troy Bayliss's, that's a 996 as well, isn't it?
Yeah,
it is.
And then the 998, wasn't it? And then they had this, I think they had this 1098 there as well.
Yeah.
999.
Yeah. I mean, you've got your...
Which one? There was one...
That is probably one of the nicest 999s that I've ever seen.
It's lovely, isn't it?
It's lovely, isn't it?
I'm trying to think which one I was looking at.
Show them around it.
Hey?
Talk about the 999. Tell them about the beauty that is the 999. Just pass you over to Mike.
He's such a belt.
His legendary bike.
So this is the 999R. They only made 1,500 of these. This is a 2004. Full carbon fairing. You can see the carbon inserts here. So in 2005 they changed that to, they did away with this. It was something to do with Ben Bostrom riding in the AMA, so it made it sleeker, so that bit was filled in. But it's just full of exotic bits and pieces.
Sexual components.
It's so nice to ride, such an unrated bike. Look at this, the detail in the carbon fibre. Don't know if you'll pick this up, but the way that it comes through in the paint there, it's just absolutely class. And it goes with the red frame. So when they originally brought it out, it came with a silver frame in 2003, and it had a different swing arm. And then they brought this double-sided swing arm out. It was very contentious at the time, because obviously it followed on from the 996 and the 998, which just had the single-sided and the twin pipes coming out the back. So everybody kicked out off about it, because that was just such an iconic style. And then you've got the twin headlight front fairing. I think this is all, yeah, this is magnesium, or can't get him. But yeah, it's I mean, look at these rocker covers here. It's absolutely mental. You've got full all-in suspension, front and rear. This one's had a Samco hose upgrade on it. It's, yeah, got different levers and grips and stuff. But as a rider's bike, it's probably one of the best to ride. It's just, somebody's changed the rear sets on it previously, but it's really, really nice. It starts up, it's quiet, but then it's got that really raucous sound to it. Don't want it to sound like an anorak here, but the special bikes that Ducati did, they did sandcast engines. So you see the casing there, it's sandcasted, as opposed to, I don't know, however, the other way of doing it. So yeah, these aren't mass produced. These are, if you like, the last of the proper raw Ducatis. This is 0702. They did 1,500 of these to homologate for the World Superbike Championship at the time. Because World Superbike, yeah, you had to bring out a certain amount of road bikes to go with, to be able to class to race them as well. But it's just a really, really tidy bit of kit, and it goes so well. It's got none of the electronic suspension. It's got none of the rider aids or anything like that. Don't get me wrong, it's not as vicious as the new big bikes. They need those rider aids, but It's the last of the, well, I suppose the 1098 is probably the last of the original big V twins without the rider aids. The 1198 came out after that, and that had the very primitive traction control system. These didn't sell so well because they were a bit of a Marmite bike, and to some people they still are now, but I love them. Yeah, I've had this for about, I don't know, 4 or 5 years now, and I don't use it as often as I should. You've seen Chris's now because there's just a bit of a weep on one of the front fork seals, and some bits and pieces weren't doing. To be fair, once it's here, you can't bloody get it back off him.
That's because it's a sexual bike, mate. it's trouser tickingly sexy.
Just say if Des is in the way, won't he?
Oh, yeah. Des, you might be in the way, sweetheart. She gives no freaks. None whatsoever. She ain't bothered, mate. Well, back wheel's back on.
So what are you on with now then, Chris? Because you're sort of holding us up, really, to be fair.
The back, the sprocket's on, nuts have been replaced. I think that has tidied the bike up no end.
Okay.
Without a doubt.
So what's happening with the front sprocket?
Front sprocket, what I'm going to have to do is because I foolishly chopped the chain off before slacking that.
Has this gone off?
No. It's just the screen. You just tap in, it comes back on. So what I'm going to have to do is you're going to have to run the new chain, unfortunately, get it all sealed up, don't tighten it down too much, and then we'll have to use that in combination with the back brake. So that locks that off, and then we can just buzz that off. But it's my own fault.
Okay, man.
I was just rushing.
Amateur hour.
That's it.
Sorry about that, folks. Once Chris sorts himself out, we'll get back on doing it. All right, cheers.
Right, so schoolboy errors were made. We got the new sprocket on, new nuts. We've come to replace the chain. Obviously, the chain is ready to go on. But the thing is that the gearbox sprocket is so tight that we cannot get it off. It will not come off at all. So we're going to have to wait for a mate of mine who's got a big impact gun to come down so we can get rid of that and then get a nice new clean shiny sprocket on there, and a nice new shiny chain will be installed. So in the meantime, Big Man has put the tank back on. We've quickly ran her up. Just to prime the oil filter, just topping it up now, finalising the oil level. Which, are we looking good?
Mm-hmm. All good.
And then, we'll run her up, just make sure everything's sound. But, yeah, it's been a progressive day with the ZX9. I'm just absolutely gutted about that chain. And that sprocket, and it's had a little wee as well. That's just all the crap that's come out from behind the sprocket, absolutely covered. What do you think about the ZX9, Doris? It does need work, doesn't it? Yeah, you're gonna have to go when it's done.
Yeah too right, Joel.
Yeah, you can have a go. It works exactly the same as your 125, but it has to be become a bit more careful with it.
No pressure.
Yeah, but don't worry about it. You've got muscles, haven't you? Sort of.
Obviously.
I know what you're saying. It's that haircut, mate. That's what I think it is. Good.
Happy days.
So we're gonna have to call that quits for this video, because I don't really think there's too much more that we can do until we can get that the sprocket thing sorted out down here. You happy with the progress, Big Mike?
Yeah, me and Joel have done really well today.
Yeah, you have, yeah. No, proper impressed, mate. No, you've done really, really well.
Thanks, buddy.
You know, it's not really much guidance needed to be given. It was just, you know, it is common sense, though, isn't it?
you know, when it comes to...
Yeah, so, yeah, there's nothing untoward, is there?
No. It actually did look in quite good nick under the tank.
Yeah,
as
it was
well,
quite clean, wasn't it?
You know, it was quite clean.
Where was I going with this?
So, I don't know, mate. I mean, I wouldn't even wipe my bum with that.
I was going to wipe Des's ass with it because she's got oil all over it.
Yeah, Mike, come here, Des. The dog.
Good girl.
So, yeah, we will call that quits here with new spark plugs, new air filter, oil filter, new sprocket, new nuts. I've checked the bearings in the back. They seem to be good. Caliper seems to be
compression
right.
Test gone all right.
Compression test was really good. The engine's nice and strong. So yeah, we will leave that as that. And from me and Mike and Doris, thank you very much for
Doris
watching.
Mac 2, Doris Mac 1.
Whatever. Margaret, go and have a brew. And then, yeah, we'll catch you in the next week or so with another video. Thanks very much for watching. We'll see you next week.